Next up is John Adache as the from Sifu County.
Well, I want to give a brief overview of the opportunities that we have as catalyst community in the heavy oil industry. And you know, Syncrude Canada is a better based. So my emphasis is going to be on bitumen and on the opportunities that we have with all the other industries that are growing, that are being put in place in Fort McMurray in particular. There is over $80 billion of money being pumped in to the Alberta economy and the oil sands industry. And I think as a catalysis community, we need to take advantage of that. And the most important thing is that it is catalysis that is mainly controlling most of these processes, or the success of most of these processes. My first slide gives an overview of the catalysis part of the industry as we see it now. And on the lower side of it, the areas of catalysis that we're looking at, where catalysts plays a role, is in we have dispersed systems, we have emulsion systems, we have slurry type systems, ablated bed and fixed bed type systems. And this goes into, first of all, it goes into the area of the primary upgrading side of things. The second upgrading side, when we've made our naphtha and we've made our light gas wells and heavy gas wells, we need to hydro treat these materials. So catalysis plays a role in that area as well. Next slide. This slide shows the classic chemical engineering look at catalyst performance. And I've tried to put all of these characteristics together just to show that for every company that is involved in the oil sand industry, at least one of these characteristics hits you. There is a problem that each, or a challenge, we don't want to use the word problems, we also want to use the word challenge. There is a challenge that faces each one of these companies. So you can take a look at the first one on the upside, which is hydrogen. Hydrogen forms one of the basic building blocks of our industry. When you look on the feed side, bitumen, heavy oil, gas oil, naphtha comes in as the feed. But the characteristics that are very important and provide lots of challenges for us is aromatics and metals. The boiling point distribution can become a factor as well. When you go down to the catalyst side, we've got a number of systems that are in place. We have solid type catalyst supported, liquid, dispersed, and biocatalysts. On the system side, when you look at the processes, we've got a slurry, the emulsion, could be either fixed bed or a ablated bed. But one of the key challenges as we go into, especially the dispersed systems or the slurry type systems, is catalyst recovery. If you look at the chemistry, I've highlighted in red aromatic saturation and ring opening. However, I've got challenges in all these areas. Some companies have got issues related to arsenic, some have got issues related to silicon, which need to be removed. Next slide. So what I've tried to put together is that I've taken a look at the challenges and then combined it with the knowledge gaps, and I have my own wish list, which are some of the areas which I feel that we could build bridges between academia and the industry. Some of the key areas that we could look at. The first area which I've highlighted with my background in hydroprocessing catalysis is a step-out catalyst system. I think the hydrotreating industry is getting fed up with nickel molding on aluminum. We need something different, something more potent than we have at the moment. So is there anything better than cobalt molding on aluminum? I think we need to investigate in that. What about carbon nanotubes? We've heard about carbon nanotubes. We should be able to take advantage of it, possibly as a support material. We're still working in the area of support effects, and I think it continues to play a very key role in how hydroprocessing is done. Hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. We need more of it, whether it is in situ, generated, or ex situ, we need more hydrogen. And as we go forward, that is going to be one of the big challenges that we're going to face in the heavy oil industry. Product quality is also an issue. How do we, the key one I've listed here, how do we perform aromatic saturation and ring opening? You know, and we find that lots of people are working in this area. And I think for the past 15 years, we have not made much of a progress. So it's one area that we need to really look at. Next slide. Now, this is another area, feed catalyst interaction, that is very close to my heart. We need to delve into the fundamentals of some of these systems, the interaction between the feed that we introduce into our reactors and the catalyst. Detailed feed and catalyst interaction characterization needs to be done. There's work going on, but we need to do more. Molecular level understanding of the feed catalyst interaction. And over here, I want to give a lot of credit to the pharmaceutical industry. They've taken molecular modeling to a very new level, and I feel that, my feeling is that the catalysis industry should take advantage of this. We can use molecular modeling very well as a screening tool. In situ feed characterization and model compounds. The question I always pose with model compounds is that, are they truly representative? We do lots of work where we realize that we pick up, we've used carbazoles, we've used pyridines, and I think we've really destroyed those compounds to death. We possibly have to move to try to use much more representative compounds as we go into much heavier feed. The last point I have here is recovery. And I've mentioned that already, that our slurry systems, our dispersed systems, we need to recover the catalyst. My final slide is on industrial academic collaboration. We've had lots of success when we've worked on fundamental and exploratory research initiatives, because this work is publishable and there's lots of leverage into it. In the area of applied research, we've had challenges, and especially the last few years where intellectual property has become a very key issue. Almost everybody wants to hold on to whatever that he or she is working on. And I think as we go down the road, this is where industry and academia should come together and know who owns what and who really owns what. The final point I want to make is on the fact that the insect chairs have worked very well and we've had lots of success in that area. But what I want to suggest is for us to move a little bit further into looking at multi-industry and then academic initiatives, where a group of companies and academia will come together and then work on particular type of projects, possibly ring opening, whichever project that might come up. Thank you.